The stress and the pollution are harmful factors so often found in the cities. The town people feel more and more the need to turn to nature in order to find their physical and mental balance there. A balance practically impossible to be found in the cities. They are attracted by the beauty, by the purity, and by the harmony of the rural life, by the unspoiled natural area. More and more tourists wish to see in reality the hospitality, the gastronomic traditions, the handicraft and the rites from the rural area, the repose, the fresh air, the consumption of fresh and healthy food, the taste of the wine and of some specialities from the peasant gastronomy are solid arguments to practice the rural tourism. The folksy art, the religion and the ancient Christian customs, the possibility to find yourself in the middle of the events characteristic for the place, evening sittings of village women, fairs, celebrations, festivals, etc., even the therapy of physical work are equally considered as places of attraction. The hunting, the sports fishing, the campings, the repose on the bank of the rivers and lakes constitute a ground to pass the vacation in other kind of conditions. How is it possible to sell or to buy the sky or the earth's warmth if the freshness of the air and the purl of the water don't belong to us? How can we sell them? If all the animals disappear, the human being will die completely alone, because everything that happens to the animals is reflected immediately upon the human being. We are the earth's constitutive part, and the earth is our constitutive part too. If the human being mocks at the earth, that means the human being mocks at himself. We know for a long time, it is not the earth that belongs to the human being, but it is the human being who belongs to the earth. We know it very well. All the things are connected between each other, in the same way as the blood makes a connection between the members of the same family. It's high time to have a look upon the things from the rural area. It's the moment of reconciliation with nature. Now, it is not too late. You, human being, bow your soul and mind towards nature. Allow the nature to live. Through nature we all live. Otherwise, World Organization for Tourism proposes that this should represent not only a simple level of marketing, but a sustainable method of development and practice of the tourism in the rural area, which corresponds to some criteria of objective and ecological administration. By adopting a series of decisions regarding the development of tourism, the Organization of United Nations expressed its appreciation and gratitude towards the social and economical role of the tourism in the creation of new working places and of the economical development. Rural tourism, the agro-tourism and the eco-tourism proved to be effective and efficient tools of sustainable development for the economy in transition.
Žabka is situated in a very picturesque place that everyone can visit and wonder about the beautiful nature that surrounds us and all the places given by God in this region. Besides the fact that the people are very good here, the nature is very good for the population too. It would be great if this locality is supported not only by our state, but also by all the European countries. During the project implemented by the Agency for Regional Development Habitat, sustained by the Eurasia Foundation and financed by the USAID, and due to the information provided by Mr. Valerio Russo, during the seminars the inhabitants from Žabka village are ready to receive about 100 tourists in their village. I had also the possibility to visit Poland and to participate in the realization of the project. In Poland I saw many beautiful things that I wouldn't like to be compared with ours. However, the Republic of Moldova is our motherland and it is the most beautiful part of the world for us. We enjoy the beautiful streams, the monastery that was never closed, even in the period when all the monasteries were closed. We also enjoy the stone, which is a vestige in a very beautiful zone that cannot be found in other regions in Moldova. There are also many relics that can be found namely here, in Žabka. I would like to say some words about Dniester River too, which runs so slowly and has such a beautiful landscape in our region. Here, everyone can have some rest and can remember the pleasant minutes spent in Zhapka. We also enjoy the householders from our village, which can show and prove their famous mastership in beekeeping, for example, or oil mills.
Под арата пошкоди мостра майстрія Лор. Куалбіні землю, комара, улойниця, де доведеться скандалі, коли сам пан господар, мамі не
тимас. The development of rural tourism, agrotourism, ecotourism will lead to a sustainable economical development of the rural localities due to the multiplying effect of this activity. The positive influences on the environment, agriculture, transports, constructions, on the alimentation and processing industries, and on the services from the most diverse fields will be felt. In order to diversify the tourist offer and to intensify the trade with souvenirs, an important development will be registered by the handicraft and domestic industry characteristic for the rural area in the past, as components of the rural tourist product influences, to put into value the folksy traditions and customs, as well as to diversify the range of activities with a cultural, educational character. The unemployment is today one of the least accepted phenomena, which affects the economies of all the countries. At the same time, it is the main problem of the contemporary society at world level. Thus, the confronting with demographic problems will provoke governments, countries, communities responsible of human rights to look for effective and efficient solutions. One of these solutions is undoubtedly the tourism. If we also add the fact that every 26 seconds in the world tourism a new working place appears, we can conclude that the world tourism became the biggest industry. We can say that this green industry constitutes much more a country, a royalty, because according to PIB, it occupies the fourth place in the world. Moldova can participate in this development of the tourism from the whole world, and especially from Europe, if it will take advantage from the offered possibilities, meaning adequate credit, banking and fiscal politics of encouraging and facilitating the rural tourism with its complementary products.
Pentru acest lucru. Pot să menționez că noi deja am făcut primii pași, negătând la faptul că sunt destul de mici, dar i-am făcut în acest domeniu. Chiar anul trecut am practicat câteva seminare cu experți din România și din Ucraina în domeniul turismului rural.
For our village, one of the main points in the economical and social growth of the village is the development of the rural tourism. I would say that this is one of the biggest facilities for our village, because it was observed that our village possesses a rather beautiful and important natural potential. I would like to mention that we have already made the first steps, though they are very small in this field. Last year, we organized some seminars with experts from Romania and Ukraine in the field of rural tourism, where we found a lot of very important things for the beginning of such a business. I would like to say that in our village one knows how to practice such kind of tourism, and one is able to do it, because we possess all the necessary potential. We are placed on the bank of Dniester River, and we have a very interesting geography and relief. We want to restore the water mills, which in the past brought a very good profit to the inhabitants of the village. Very beautiful places are, for example, the Pit of Livia, the House of the Bride, which I am sure are worth visiting and will be pleasant for the tourists. In my opinion, the householders from our village
don't dispose only of adequate sanitary conditions to receive a tourist, but this problem can be solved. I think that the rural tourism will contribute to the social and economic development of the village, and why not, to the keeping of the youth in the villages. At the same time, we have the possibility to perform a pleasant and profitable affair. In my opinion, the development of rural tourism should be developed not only regionally, but also nationally. Because in order to come to beautiful places, we need to have good roads. But in our localities and in many others, the roads are in a bad condition. I hope we'll manage to develop the rural tourism in our village, because we have at our disposal all the necessary potential. As I am the mayor of this village, and I know the situation in the Republic of Moldova, I mean the period of transition of our economy, then I would say that the rural tourism is a profitable affair not only for our village, but for the entire Republic too.
Socola, Ușmirca și Estaci, deci la localitățile din partea dinspre Nistru este acest drum este destul de anevoios. Eu sper că turismul rural va ajunge și în localitățile din comuna noastră, ne va aduce un venit bun, fiindcă dispunem de un potențial destul de bun pentru a începe acest lucru. Eu, ca conducător al acestei comune, ca primar, vreau să spun că în aceste condiții destul de drastice pentru Republica noastră, în această epocă de trecere, să-i spun așa, turismul rural ne-ar aduce niște venituri destul de favorabile, nu numai pentru satul nostru, dar și pentru întreaga Republică. Dar referindu-mă la satul nostru, vreau să spun că din aceasta ar avea de câștigat atât agenții economici, administrația publică locală, în primul rând aș menționa administrația publică locală, agenții economici și nu în ultimul rând localnicii acestui sat.
The development of tourist activities in the rural area will contribute to the establishment of the youth in the hearts of the villages, will motivate them, and especially the feminine population, to take part in these activities. Thus, they won't have to leave their homes in order to earn their money abroad, which many times brings them to criminal consequences. New working places will be created in the field of production and distribution of tourist services by the multiplying effect on the related branches. Economically, the rural tourism is characterized by a large series of activities. It has multiple tasks in the growth of its economical and social efficiency, the increase of its contribution to the internal product.
The village of Rashkov, situated at a distance of 16 kilometers from the regional center Kamenka, is situated on an ancient ford of Nistu River. The first documentary attestation dates from 142 with the title Kalaur. Then it was a limited fortification of the Latvian kingdom situated near the forest with the same title. Later it belonged to Rechi Pospolita and then was a territory of Ukraine. It passed through a prosperous period in the 17th and 18th centuries. Beginning with 1655, Ruxandra, the daughter of the ruler Vasily Lupu, lived here, this territory being the wedding gift from the part of the bridegroom's father, Bogdan Khmelnytsky, the hetman of Ukraine. Simultaneously, with the loss of the strategic value of the fortress, the region of Rashkov becomes village, but it still preserves some eloquent proofs of its former urban ascent. The cultural dwellings of the religious communities, constructed by the Moldovans, Ukrainians, Poles and Jews, are also preserved. The ruined church Saint Mother's Falling Asleep traditionally carries the name of Ruxandra. In the south of the village, lower from the Nistu River's flow, the Red Mountain is situated, a very weathered massive of stone in which the wind and the rain have sculptured strange figures. Lathes, suspended bridges. Nearby there is a tectonic figure called the Deep Valley, which has the length of half a kilometer, the depth of about 50 meters, and the width of only 5 meters. There, the stream Lady's Well flows,
which according to the legend was formed by the tears of Oksana. Rashkov is an old center of wine production. In some cellars fitted out for the consumers, the famous wine Riesling Deren can be served. The travelers and tourists, the itinerary of which will pass through Wado Rashkov and Rashkov, besides the beauty created by nature and by God, will also find many more monuments of a certain historic and architectural value. Inevitably, the useful effects of the tourist activities will have a multidimensional character. Thus, the economical efficiency of the tourism is associated with the social efficiency, which results from providing the conditions to rebuild the working capacities, to have a delightful and useful spare time, to raise the level of general culture and professional grounding, with the diversification of the services, the realization of some psychological, intellectual or spiritual motivations. It can be considered that the social efficiency represents the contribution of the tourist financial base in the implication of many more individuals in the practice of tourism, in order to provide the best conditions of recovering the working capacities or the implication, especially of the youth, in the active and educative repose with multiple educational effects. At the same time, through the relationships established during tourism actions, by any kind of changes realized in the international tourism, pacific, diplomatic and deeply democratic values are discovered, which will contribute to the realization of strong relationships and to the decrease of all the distances, and in future to the abolition of the borders and to the realization of at least a unified Europe. It can be affirmed that the tourism will contribute to recreation, restoration and comfort, enriching the knowledge and blooming the human personality, establishing at the same time a climate of peace and understanding between nations. The Saharna Monastery in the range of sister monasteries is a very beautiful monastery because, firstly, it is situated in a natural landscape surrounded by hills and forests, and it is also ornamented by a stream, famous in the whole world by the curing effects of its water, which is called the Stream of Wonders. The Saharna Monastery is also one of the oldest settlements of the monks. Some old churches from stone are preserved till now here. In this landscape reservation, the monasteries, the churches, the stream, the rock with the monastery in stone have a wonderful position, which attracts many believers. And not only believers, but tourists also. The persons that come to visit the monastery pass virtually through all historical moments of these places. The believers are gathering here in these sacred places from all over the world, because these places constitute not only a pearl of our region and country, but this is also our pride for the places where we live. For many years, the Agency for Regional Development Habitat, conducted by Valeriu Rusu, helps us a lot to collaborate and to attract many tourists to the Stream of Wonders and to all the other monuments. Mr. Valeriu and we too have a strong wish to make our natural monuments famous and attractive by the creation of tourist itineraries. That is why we are always glad to receive Christians, guests, tourists and pupils in our monastery in the Saharna village and in all our historically sacred places.
Și noi, în mica noastră Moldova, dar destul de frumoasă, avem așa locuri care minunează.
Launching the Bessarabian tourist village on the world market will lead to special effects regarding the connections realized in future between the hosts and the tourists, the reports between the way the values are appreciated and the life level between these two participants to the tourist action, the way of solving some new situations, communication and exchange of opinions, relationships that are established between the host and the beneficiary, the guest and the tourist. The civil community from the rural area will promptly respond to the social command of restoration in the middle of a natural, unpolluted, balanced and beneficial frame. The novelty of the rural tourist product, the existing conditions, the culture and purity of the people and of places, doubled by their hospitability, interest, motivation and strive for better, will impose and assign the Bessarabian tourist village. All this will contribute to the sustainable and responsible development of the village, producing inevitable changes that will diminish their dependence to the town. The rural localities, where the rural agricultural and ecological tourism will be practiced, are going to become spaces containing all the elements for local sustainable development. The interest for infrastructure improvement and of constitution of a spiritual life will appear. Thus, the support of improving the public services will be created. It will be observed that the rural tourism has a complex influence on the external medium, economical, social, cultural, environmental, putting a mark on the general level of economical development of the respective localities. The strategic objectives regarding the assurance and the protection of the human factor, the technical equipment and the patrimony conservation, thus classified in three directions of action, will be realized, stopping the migration of the population from the rural area and stimulating at least the partial return of the population from the urban to the rural localities, assuring the adequate living and civilization conditions in the rural area by stimulating the establishment of the active population in the rural area. Conservation and protection of the rural area, factor of attraction of the local population and of the foreigners towards the rural area. The rural ecological and cultural tourism at the launching of its complementary product on the international market will become a cultural and educational ambassador, a constant and inexpensive tool for the social progress of the village. And namely, the continuity of the agricultural activities in the weekly productive medium, the prevention, respectively the decompression of the towns from the raising of the unemployment rate, the disalienation of the urban society, of the generations born and raised up in blocks from concrete and re-establishing their contact with the earth, the major contribution to raise the general degree of civilization and of a big category of population. We mean the peasants, which are more isolated, especially by improving their hygienic and sanitary conditions, their social behavior and the cultivation of their aesthetical taste. The rural, agricultural, ecological and sustainable tourism offers to the citizens from the rural area of the Republic opportunities and mechanisms to live the desired life with a stable future for themselves and for their children. The development of the rural business, including the rural tourism too, based on the managerial knowledge and on the non-pollution technologies, in harmony with the principles of sustainable development, will surely become money harvest for the inhabitants of the villages of the Republic, assuring a decent life and a working places at their homes.